General Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, and by extension, the military bosses of Egypt, have been tormenting the brave people of Egypt. Despite the billions of dollars that have been pouring in supporting al-Sisi, the Egyptian regime has nothing to show in ways of progress but misery. The Egyptian army and their dear leader started by toppling an elected president. Even if the man who ended up dying in prison was too Islamist for them, he was still duly elected. Then they went on governing by starting in earnest to eliminate the political opposition with thousands of people in prison. Every part of society has been hurt or silenced. Human rights activists, independent journalists, opposition politicians, foreign observers, social media personality, even TikTokers are either in prison or have been intimidated to the point that they no longer speak. Many have died, murdered. Bribes have been allegedly paid to foreign politicians and influencers to buy their support, allegedly. In the area of so-called national security, al-Sisi military men have crushed the people of the Sinai Peninsula because of the alleged presence of the jihadists in the region. Egypt has been using warfare against the people of Sinai just because they are presumably guilty by association. On the economic front, Sisi's tenure so far has been a disaster. And in a recent speech, the general said, and I am paraphrasing, quote, "If the price of Egypt's progress and prosperity is hunger and misery, then let us starve," end of quote. He was not joking when he said that, though he himself is not starving at all. Now consider this, not only the value of the Egyptian pound collapsed, but food prices went up 72% over last year. People are literally hungry. In a country that produced intellectual giants, scientists, business tycoons, and artists, like Taha Hussein, Abdurrahman Badawi, Zahi Hawass, and singer Abdul Halim Hafid, to name just these four, the news from the world of finance is not good for Egypt. Global economic entities representing businesses and investors' interests are putting enormous pressure on al-Sisi to try to fix things. But not only the Egyptian economy is controlled by incompetent soldiers who have no skills to manage a nation of more than 100 million people, but the ship has too many holes leaking at the same time that it is hard to know where to start. This week, Moody's downgraded Egypt's credit rating from B3 to Caa1 because Egypt carries a massive debt and worsening debt affordability. The country does not have enough foreign currency and has high inflation, and so Moody's and others are hoping Egypt will start selling state assets in the form of a privatization so it can use that money to compensate for a weak financial and debt position. And on the other hand, the IMF, which has made a meager $3 billion available for Egypt, is also hitting it hard. To be clear, the situation is so dire in Egypt that there is nothing on the horizon that seems to fix the problem. And so the country is progressively headed toward collapse, a situation that the regime does not seem to comprehend. Egyptian leaders believe, truly believe, that the country is too big to fail. If a revolution will come, they think foreign countries will come to the rescue because they will not want a destabilized Egypt that would turn the Middle East upside down. Al-Sisi has been using the destabilization card to force the Gulf monarchies and the United States to come to its rescue all the time. So now Sisi and his military syndicate assume the prospect of instability could be used once again as a bargaining chip to extort more money from allies. So what do all these warnings from foreign investors and analysts mean for Egypt's midterm outlook? Not too great. 2024 will be an extremely difficult year for Egypt, And things could spiral out of control to the point that El Sisi ordered the presidential election to be fast-tracked to December of this year instead of 2024. Sisi will clearly secure his seat once again before the devaluation of the pound would send the Egyptian people to the streets. He will use, as usual, questionable election, but we must be prepared for heightened tension in Egypt next year because, unlike what Sisi thinks, Egypt is not too big to fail, and it could fail.